Hi everyone, and welcome back to the channel. I'm Infantry Pulse, and today we're going to be doing something just a little bit more fun, just kind of going through the mythics and putting them in this little tier list I've got made up for you. So this will just kind of give you a clue as to what mythics are worth investing into, and just kind of a general discussion of where we stand with mythics right now on September 19th, 2020. So we're going to just go in alphabetical order just to make it easiest. So that first one up is actually Altina. So Altina is an offensive mythic. She grants attack bonuses, and she's kind of an offensively oriented hero. So she is built to be a vantage unit. And because of that, I think she's just kind of meh. So she's not bad by any means, but you want your mythics to probably be more supportive overall. I use two Altinas to boost up my Kranya's attack, but really they just become smite bots at the end of the day. They're good for cleaning up units that maybe your main unit is incapable of killing. They have really good like offensive power, especially running something like Heavy Blade with their exclusive special that bypasses damage reduction. That can be really good, but as far as like any kind of support option, it's just not there. They are flying, so that can kind of help with like some guidance, aerobatics kind of stuff. But overall, just really kind of meh, because all the other mythics, for the most part, offer like some kind of support or, you know, like great offensive strategy. And she's just there to kind of be a vantage unit. And since she can't get mythic blessed herself and get those bonuses, there are other units that just do it better. Okay, next up we have Bramimond, and Bramimond is actually, I do use him in my dark defense, and he is absolutely just an incredible unit. He's just god tier beyond great offensively. His C skill that makes you 1v1 him is crazy in that it just removes all support that your opponent has on their tank or whatever, and he just dishes out an crazy amount of damage with his tome, with guaranteed follow-ups. He's got a really good base kit also, so he's ready to go pretty much out of the box, and Bramimond is one of those mythics that I would recommend you picking up right away as soon as you see him. Next up is Duma, and Duma was one of our first released mythics. He's got some pretty good stats, but at the end of the day, he's an armored dragon. So he has double weakness, he has one movement, and he's a defensive hero, which means he's in the control of the AI. So when I used Duma back when it was like more of a requirement just for scoring options, I used more of a corner strat and just put him with distant counter and special fighter. And he doesn't even survive even with those tools and his high defenses and everything. He just gets killed too easily. That's really what it is. His ability to be effectively a catapult that can destroy your opponent's structures, that's probably his biggest advantage. So he deals 7 damage to them at the beginning of combat, whatever, but his ability to be a max level catapult and take out a structure can actually be somewhat useful if you're looking to, for example, guarantee eliminating your opponent's bolt tower, if that's really important to your strategy. So he has some uses there, but that's at the beginning of the fight, and then for the rest of the fight, he's dead weight. So I just think he's bad. I think he's not good at all. Next up, we have Air. So Air is free for us. Everyone gets an Air from the beginning of the game, which is really great because she is a great unit. She is a good offensive unit. She grants res, which is a great stat for your tanks in offense. She has passive healing. She's a dagger unit, so she can use her Tamari dagger, or you can stick with her default Liefeberg, which is just a great offensive dagger. You can put Fury on her, Fury 3 or Fury 4, and use the Air 4 strategy, which basically involves you getting Air to pretty low health within Wings of Mercy range, and then going off with Gale Force units from there. So by using Disarm Trap and Fury, she can be just a really, really good anchor for a Gale Force team to clean up teams really fast. So Air Force is a great strategy, and that's part of what makes her so great. But really, I think it's the passive healing and the fact that she grants res to your offense units that make her a standout mythic hero. And then Mommy Dearest, Hell. So Hell is recently released. She has her passive that lets her, or not her passive, her weapon that makes her not die. And I think that makes her good. I don't think she's great. I think she's good. So she's hard countered by mages. And if it wasn't for that, she would be great or, you know, incredible, like god tier. But the fact that she's hard countered by mages makes her not as great. She's still really good. And if you run Mystic Boost on her, she can become invincible unless the opponent has a way to counter her. So she can be really, really strong in that regard if you run Mystic Boost on her to keep her above that 1% HP threshold. And unless your opponent has a way to counter that, she just literally cannot die. So that's really, really awesome for her, obviously. That's really cool. But barring that, and the fact that she is weak to mages, and that Peony exists, not that Peony can really, like, kill her, but Peony is a light season offensive mage. And so if you get Hell down to super, super, super low health, Peony can poke her down to size, you know. Bolt Towers also exist, so if Bolt Tower chips Hell down to one health, then her weapon is not effective at all. But she is a good unit. She's also great on Flyer Balls, because she is a flying unit, and I think Flyer Balls are generally better on Dark Season than they are on Animus Season. So she has some really great strengths, but she has that big glaring weakness also, so that just kind of puts her in the middle here of good. Next up we have Lif, and Lif has a really interesting kit. He's really built more for Aether Raid's offense, ironically, than he is for Aether Raid's defense, and because of that, I think he's kind of bad. He's definitely better than Duma, but he is just kind of bad. His sword dealing chip damage to your units can be really, really painful. It can be really hindering to you. And he can just get blown up. Like, he is a red sword infantry, and, you know, blue nukes exist, Ophelia exists, Reinhardt exists, and there are lots of units that can just take him down pretty quickly. When I personally used Lif, I actually just nixed his pref sword entirely and used a Wodao Glacies build just to make him, like, effectively just a really big nuke. His deadly balance skill is actually quite good for granting him special charges. He also has that Open the Future special skill, which gives him effectively a bonfire and noontime kind of combination. And those are all great things that work in his favor. Just what doesn't work in his favor are his kind of weird stat allocation and that really bad 20 damage that he deals to your allies. So he can be a good defense unit and he can be very threatening. But I find just baiting him out with a tank can usually end up killing him. So, you know, he's not the worst in the world, but he's not as good as Altina, in my opinion anyway, and he's just not great by any means. I think he's pretty bad. Okay, next up is Mila, Mother Mila. So she is Goddess of Life, and she has that isolation effect, and because of that, that makes her great. Really great, actually. I almost put her in Incredible, I think, but I think she's just great because Mila's turn wheel and her isolation effect and her preferred weapon that gives +2 to all stats in a huge range, those are really great things, but her as a unit herself kind of lacks. So she's got that slow speed, even with her high defenses. Because she's an infantry unit, not an armored unit, she doesn't have access to wary fighter or anything, so she will always get doubled. And that can be really bad for her, even with her great defenses, because her HP is going to be comparatively low compared to other Aether Raid's units, because she can't be blessed, because she's a mythic hero. So her HP is going to be comparatively low. The great thing about her, though, is that isolation effect, preventing your opponent's dancers from doing anything at all. And also the fact that she grants you an extra turn. That's something that's often overlooked, is that extra turn can help you get those last Aether structures that you may have missed if it was turn 7. So she's got some really good just support that goes really well for her. I'm going to place her better than Air, even though Air has Air Force and everything. I think Mila's isolation effect has been super meta-defining, and I think that says something for how incredible a unit she is, how great a unit she is. Not quite incredible, because, you know, her as a unit herself is not the best in the world, but she's great. She is great. She's super, super cool unit to use. She also grants defense, which, you know, for a super tank strategy is great. I use, personally, in Light Season, I use a Mila and an Air together, so my unit is getting +10 HP, +5 defense, +5 res. makes them a super great tank. Okay, next up, Mirabilis. Mirabilis is a recent addition to my Anima season defense, and the fact that she's a dancer, the fact that she has, you know, this huge debuff in her dance and her preferred sword, I think that makes her an incredible unit. I think that she is absolutely an awesome unit. The fact that she is just a great, great, great support unit. And that's really what you want out of your mythics, right? So you want your mythics to not only be, like, Braymion is a great, like, nuke. He's a great offensive unit. But really what you want is you want support. You want a great support unit to back up all your other units that are going to do the work, that can receive the blessings of something like a Mirabilis and put that to use, you know? So I think that her ability to dance, the fact she's a flying dancer, so she can use ground orders and guidance and aerobatics and all these different things to increase your team's movement, I think that you can't overstate how helpful she is as a support unit, how incredible she can be to debuff your opponent's teams as well as refresh your own units. Just a great support unit. Next up, we have Naga. So Naga was our only Astra Mythic for a long time, and still we only have Altina and Naga. And I don't think she's good. I think she's pretty bad, actually. The fact that she grants defense makes her okay, but I don't think she's that good. just because her only really thing she has going for is that she grants dragon effectiveness, which can be good if you're, like, trying to take out a really strong Duma, and that's part of also what makes Duma not great, is that he shares a season with Naga, and Naga grants dragon effectiveness to any unit, so all of a sudden Duma is getting hit by everything with effective damage, and so his good defenses don't even matter. So, as far as Naga goes, she does have some use in terms of her preferred tome, or preferred breath, rather, granting her a bunch of extra stats based on how many dragons you have and how many dragon effective weapons you have. I personally, when I have my Naga that I use Distant Counter, Quick Riposte, and I can use that to bait out some units sometimes. I throw an Eye Out Shield on her. That way, she can actually tank some bow users on a cav line, and I've actually used her to some effect with that, but that's like a very specific thing, and it's only sometimes. It's not all the time for sure. And the fact that she is flying and a dragon gives her two weaknesses, especially because she shares a season with Thrasir, and Thrasir is A, green, and B, dragon effective. That means Naga just, like, gets sneezed on by Thrasir and is dead. So, she does kind of end up being just, you know, a smite bot a lot of the times, or, you know, just there to grant the extra defense. Not the best unit in the world, for sure. Next up, we have Peony, and Peony is another free unit that we get. Everyone has a Peony, just like everyone has an Air. And Peony is incredible. Peony is absolutely great. She enables so many strategies, especially things like Gale Force or Hit and Run, and the fact that she grants speed makes her even better to support those kinds of units. Her ability to grant, you know, an orders buff to everyone within her cardinal directions when she dances, she's, again, a flying dancer, so she has aerobatics, she has guidance, she has ground orders, and her special dance grants everyone on her team, basically, an orders buff, even if they're not by her at the beginning. So she enables so many strategies to work so effectively. I don't use my Peony enough, to be honest with you, but she is absolutely one of the best mythic units because, you know, I can't understate how much, like, you want your mythics to be support units, and Peony and Mirabilis, our fairies up here, are two of the best support units in the game. You know, like, I mean, they're not legendary Azura, obviously, but they're probably right below her in terms of how great they can be to support a team, especially in a mode like Aether Raids. Next up, we have Sothis. So Sothis is one of my favorite units. You know, if you've watched some of my videos, I really like my Miracle Sothis that I use on Dark Season. That being said, she is the worst mythic unit. She is absolutely the worst mythic unit. Duma is only above her here because he has that catapult effect. Sothis is great because she doesn't have the dragon weakness like Naga and like Duma. That makes her good, and she has built-in distant counter, but that's about where her boons stop. Other than that, she has basically nothing going for her. She has a good stat spread. She can get pretty fast. That's why I build my Sothis for speed on my defense team. And she does grant res, which can be, you know, okay. It can be pretty okay for your defense team. But her, like, exclusive special Sirius, as good as that can be, it's not great. And she still does get destroyed by most offensive units. That's just the way it goes. The fact that she's infantry is helpful because she can be part of an infantry pulse team, namesake. But other than that, she does not have a lot going for her. And that's sad because I do like my Sothis a lot, but she is probably the worst mythic hero in my opinion. If you don't think so, I mean, obviously I use her still, so she's still good to use in some instances. If you don't think so, leave me a comment telling me why you think, you know, Sothis is great. I will probably agree with you because I also think Sothis is great, but she's objectively speaking, she's, you know, not the best unit around. Next up, we have Thrasir. Thrasir is, you know, just an incredible nuke, and that puts her up here probably on par with Bramimonde. So between these two, you could say one is better than the other. You know, like, it's really up to you. They're both great nukes at the end of the day. They're both just super, super great nukes, just taking out almost anything in their path. In a lot of ways, they're delete buttons. It's hard to tank through with Thrasir because she stops your guaranteed follow-up, so she stops Quick Repose, Vengeful Fighter, Crafty Fighter, that kind of stuff. And she has that desperation effect, so she will double you before you can hit back in a lot of times. And she'll hit you if she's running her default kit with Flashing Blade 4, then she'll hit you with True Damage and then probably a Moonbow on the second hit, or Ruptured Sky if they're invested. Or if they're like on my team, they're running a pre-charge special because she is infantry, and that means she can get pre-charge with Infantry Pulse. So I run Luna on her, and she'll destroy Altinas. Like, that's the thing, is people will bait a Thrasir with an Altina, and it just doesn't work. Unfortunately, they really want it to work. They really want, because, you know, Altina is red and she has pretty high res, you think that, you know, Thrasir being a green mage with low defense will go down to Altina. It just doesn't work. Thrasir is just too strong. So that just makes her just a great unit, an incredible nuke. She also grants defense, which, you know, can be good if you're trying to build up defense for your frontline unit as well. Last but not least, we have Yun. Yun is Green Mage Flyer, again, one of our earlier mythics that we got. She has a good debuffing effect, and she actually gets a guaranteed follow-up and bonus attack if your opponent has a penalty, that kind of stuff. All that considered, though, I would still say she's pretty meh. Probably better than Altina, though, if you get on the right side. There you go. So, she is good in that she's a flying unit that can grant air orders, ground orders, all this kind of stuff. She's a Dark Season flying mythic, so like hell. She can work in a flyer ball. She grants speed, which makes her extra good in a flyer ball. And she has that, you know, that guaranteed follow-up, the plus 6 attack. I just think her attack stat in general, though, is too low for her to really be great. I think she wasted too many of her points into res, in terms of her stat allocation. And so, for example, like, I use a light Noe, and I know people will meme me for using a dragon still in 2020, but I use my Noe, and Noe usually takes 0 damage from a Yun. She usually doesn't get debuffed by Yun's effect because she can stack res pretty well, and, you know, air existing means that you run double air or even single air, and your res will get higher, high enough that you're not getting debuffed by Yun anymore. And so Yun doesn't get her effects off and deals 0 damage and then gets hit back by effective damage. And that doesn't feel good for Yun. So I think she can be good. I definitely think you can build a team around her, especially, you know, building ground orders, that kind of stuff around her. That's good for support. And she can still nuke units down. Like, I know I just railed on her for a little bit about my Noe, even with color triangle disadvantage, but she can still nuke units down. And so she's just okay. So those are our mythics right now. We'll get a new mythic at the end of the month. If you have any thoughts about this, if you think I've placed someone wrong, let me know in the comments. Let's start a discussion about it. Like, you could shift a bunch of these units around and it would probably still be cool, you know, but this is where I think they land. Let me know what you guys think. I will talk to you later. See you later.